losing my mind, hoping someday I would find the perfect one and I could share. And then that day you walked inside, and no longer could I hide my love.
Serious. Who is that? Who is that?
You know we got to know that about girl.
Do you know?
Buddy, this is a death matter. Buddy, make me go shake her. Today there she fall on a trap inside.
Move, go, move,
go.
God. I'm very sorry.
Hey, why? You won't kill us. Eh?
I'm really sorry.
You and your bro also so rushing the rush plus your right.
I'm really sorry.
Oh, come on for that. Pusha, relax. Relax. Pusha, relax. Pusha, relax. Relax.
You don't say like she nearly kill us.
Guys, please. I'm really sorry.
You see? See somebody where they call him body driver. You they drive, we walk my day in your ears. Why you no correct? You tell your bro, the day we are going.
I said I'm sorry, I know.
That's Masha, that's okay, that's okay.
Oh, baby, oh, shut up. Oh, baby, now. Why you treat him like he be?
Why? You they love her? Eh?
So you see, she just stood there and ignored me. She didn't say one word like I was talking to a stone. Anyhow, I will. Listen, I'm gonna have to call you back, okay? Yeah, I will. I promise. Yo, that's my jam!
Hey, Max, lower the volume. You're not alone.
Ma, please, this is my favorite music video.
I don't care what it is, Max. The point is, you're disturbing. Do you want me to come there myself?
Ma, please, just this once, okay? This is a great video.
Max, I hate arguments, and you know that. You either go and use the TV upstairs, or I'll come and turn it off myself.
Ma, please, okay? This is a great video, and I can't afford to miss any of it, okay? All right. You win, okay? I'll tell you what. I'll just the earphones so that the noise doesn't bother your precious little ears, okay? Step back and chill. Your heart is your price is pill. I remember when
I was real small. You children of today, I don't blame you. Look at what they show on TV these days. Such obscenities. Masha, what happened?
I just almost had an accident.
An accident? With a car?
Ma, come on, this is not unheard of. I mean, this shouldn't bother anybody.
Look, Max, if you're not concerned, just shut up, okay? Marcia, what happened?
And your car, what's about the car? Did you bring it back? Is it in one piece?
I don't know what to say. I left it there, but the car's fine.
What?
You did what? Masha, you think it's safe? When I think of all those, I mean, Marsha, look, we have more enemies in this neighborhood than King David did in the
Bible. Give her a break, okay? If you can't sympathize with her, just, she's been through a lot, okay?
Yes, Mama, I know. She's been through so much, but look on the bright side, okay? She's back home safe and physically sound. Now, that's good and lucky enough. Now, about the car, where did the accident happen?
Around the barbering shop.
Shark's barbershop?
Yes.
Boy, oh boy, that's right, smack in the middle of enemy territory. Where do those holy guys hang out? Look, if those barbaric ruffians, especially...
If you're talking about Bibi and Pusha, then that's...
Then what?
That's like hitting the nail right on the head. That the ones are kneeling down with a car.
Hold up. Wait a minute. Hold up. You almost hit Bibi and Pusha.
But who are those two anyway? Who are they?
Oh, come on, Ma. Who doesn't know those losers? Those couple of boys died once some time ago by the German noise in the street, remember?
Oh my God!
Yes.
They would even think that
exactly,
she
was... Exactly, Mom, that's the point. They even think that it was sort of deliberate. You know, like Marsha was trying to show up for something crazy. Boy, those two are crazy enough to make this thing bigger than it really is.
Goodness.
Marsha, did they bully you?
No, it was my fault.
I don't care whose fault it was. Did they bully you or not?
No, they didn't. Surprisingly, Bibi felt sorry for me. I was stunned by his mellow attitude. But Pusha, you know how he is.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I do. He was rough and aggressive, right?
Perhaps it could have been worse if Bibi tried to calm him down. That guy scared me to death. I was literally shaking.
Look, if they are so much as laid a finger on you, I mean, who do they think they are anyway? The mafia or death row gangsters? Anyway, to hell with that. So where is the car? Same spot near the barbershop, right?
Yes.
Fine. I'm going for the car myself. Give me the key.
Oh my God.
What?
I left it in the car.
You left the keys in the car.
Marsha! How could you do this now? Do you have any idea of the risk that is involved in what you just did? No, of course you don't. So let me tell you, okay? There are two goats in this scenario. One waits secretly by your car and the other one dashes off somewhere to make contact for your car to be stolen. Do you have any idea what these guys are made of? What guarantee do I have that if I go there, the car will still be there?
Charlie, push up. Before God and man, I've seen girls, but Charlie, Masha is, she's different.
See,
what? Did you notice her girls?
See,
goodness.
Hey, I'm not saying they love her.
Charlie.
Oh, fuck.
I'm not saying she'll kill you plus in body. Where's fast she could take right in herself?
Hey, what deal? Masha.
She, buddy. So you get good. Masha,
are you crazy?
Oh, what? Look, will you turn your back on Miss Ghana if she offers you scholarship?
Then what is the way?
Masha, but
it's over. I just make you move on. Come on.
Hey, Bapadi, what do you mean? This girl there, she's pure. Don't go there. She's pure. Who are you? Look, she's not like that today of yours. So make her tell me. Woman be woman. Why you wearing a figure?
Look,
Masha is different.
You should say veggie day Ghana today. 10-year-old girl self, Nala.
Do you know the number of guys she's bounced? Bango.
Sheka, Talibanese guy, high priestess.
What
is this? Charlie, the alloy room don't be easy. Don't go there. I'm back.
Alarm and things all.
Where?
Baby, come see, come see. The girl left the key for the right side.
You sure?
Oh, come see. You see her? Bingo! Charlie, I have to act fast. I have to take a quick drive around the area first. And then they can have their car back.
Baby, this is your chance.
Push
up. What do
you? You take the right go give them, then you make the move finish. Don't go lose guard.
I'll risk this. Even if she bounces me, Charlie, my mind.
What do you?
Push out! Push out! Charlie, I'll go come. I'll go come.
What do you, Sobride?
Shit!
Easy! Come on!
Easy! Come
on! Marsha, sometimes you kids don't tell the truth. Are you sure you're telling me the truth about everything that happened this afternoon? You didn't go outside the neighborhood?
Ma, I only brought the day back home. When she visits, I don't like her going home all by herself. She complains that the boys have been hassling her too much. Maybe I should just walk her home instead.
That girl. Are you sure she's good company for you?
Oh, yes.
Do you trust her that much?
Ma, she looks up to me. Not just as a friend, but a big sister in a way. And ever since we became friends, she takes every single advice I give her so well. Otherwise, she wouldn't be coming here, would she?
Well, really, certainly, maybe.
Ma, that sounds like we're best friends, right?
Sure, we are.
Then tell me what's on your mind about the day. I realized you weren't exactly comfortable when she came to see me today. Do you have anything against her?
That would be gossiping. The bottom of the matter is, I know her mother very well, and you are getting to know Didi.
Ma.
Anyway, did Mrs. Pupilampo bring the things
yes,
this afternoon?
Yes, she brought it and I left it. Ma, please don't change the subject. Are you saying Didi could be vulnerable?
What do you mean vulnerable? Which 15-year-old girl today isn't vulnerable?
Ma, now you're getting quite unrealistic.
You want to listen to something very interesting?
Yes.
I'm an experienced doctor, and a good one, I believe. And I can assure you that Dede isn't the virgin that you think she is.
But...
she's had a man on top of her more than once. You know, I only had to take one long, hard observation of her.
But... I can't imagine Dede isn't...
That's okay. Doctors don't have that magic. I just meant to trick you. But on a serious note, I think Dede is a spoiled girl.
But I can't imagine Dede isn't. Then she's been lying to me. Lying.
Why are you so surprised, Matthew?
Because this is so, I don't know. But how could you tell? Was it by her attitude?
You're surprised. But not as surprised as I was when I discovered that you were not a virgin.
Me too. Mana, sis, I think you're joking.
Joking? What makes you think I'm joking? Why should I joke about this? Okay, don't you have a boyfriend?
Ma, even if I had one, that doesn't mean... I mean...
No.
But you won't be your problem.
I don't have a problem, okay? You do. Now, my sister was here a short while ago and she said she ran
into... She nearly killed us. She not tell you.
Hey. Look. Just chill, okay? Because I wasn't here and I don't know what happened. Bottom line is she left the car parked somewhere around here with the key still inside. Now, since you've been lurking around here, can you please tell me where my car is?
Hey. My buddy. If you know what my buddy said. Tanta papo. I don't see your sister in car. What did she say I didn't hang around for you?
Because everybody knows that you have nothing better to do with your time.
Hey.
But let me tell you this, we will surely meet again.
Oh, sure!
Especially if, or should I say since, you know something about our car disappearing from here.
Hey. You say waiting. Chill for that!
Baby,
I brought you your car.
Thank you.
Sorry for Pusha's behavior.
Never mind. Is there a problem?
No, I... See you later.
Bye. The car is by. Did you see it outside?
What?
The car.
Yeah, I saw it when I came in, and you know, it's funny, I was just having the feeling that either you or somebody else was, you know, pulling my leg. Mm. Yeah. Mm. So, how did the car get here?
Oh, Bibi drove it here.
What?
What a surprise he gave me. Didn't you meet him on the way?
Yeah, I got that. You just told me that riffraff, that street rogue, he sat in this BM, and he drove it to this house?
Yes, he did.
look, Marsha, look. Just level with me, okay? Because right now, I'm more confused than an Eskimo running around in the Achimota forest. So just tell me one thing. What the hell is going on with you and this guy and the car?
Nothing.
What's up?
Charlie, be like you're right, though. I'm gonna risk a move on it.
Relax,
Charlie. As for this chick, her eyes, her lips, Charlie, her legs.
I see a proper. Come on.
Charlie, you didn't waste time. That means after me, it did travel past me. Go here when she fly. I'll give you 1 week.
Only 1 week. Masha Menta.
Oh,
who be here?
Women, they mind they like egg. You knock small, you go crack. You start commoting less. Like if they commode the egg in the she will talk. No, plenty. By ox, no stop. Then you win. Did it? That small girl, then she be virgin before I break down. You know how they stop when she made before I break down.
Charlie, that's alright. I'm making a move by hook or crook. Charlie, you know your phone number.
You need to ask. Push away,
you don't do the thing. Push out! Push out! I'm going to make the move.
Hi, sis.
Hey.
Are you busy? Can I talk to you for a minute?
Sure.
Hey, listen, I just got some ice cream. Your favorite flavors. I have pistachio,
Max.
I have hazelnut.
Max, what is it?
Nothing. Did Mom leave the biscuits out? I told her when she was going.
She didn't. What do you want to talk about?
Look, I. Marcy, why? I mean, are you sure you want somebody like that street ruffian, that riffraff, that rogue Bibi for a friend? I mean, come on, when I even think about it, if Dad were to see you as much as nodding hello to this riffraff,
Max, those are all previous misconceptions. Just wait till you meet him. He's a really nice guy. On the outside, he wants people to believe he's a rogue. But on the inside, he has a strong element of decency.
Oh my, strong element. Are you listening to yourself? Marsha, look. Let me tell you something, okay, sweetheart? Look, that, okay, is just some old piece of, window dressing the guy's putting up right in front of your pretty face. Now, let me tell you, listen, do you have any idea the lengths any guy, except me, of course, would go to get a girl's body? Now let's take this BB friend of yours, for instance. Now, this rogue is somebody with an uncontrolled street life, and do you know what guys like that do when they get their hands on a beautiful girl like you? You give them an inch, they take a mile, and before you know it, boom! They're on top of you, just like that. Marcy, you're 17.
Would you just lay off, Max? I can take care of myself. If this is about counseling me, then you're just stepping wrong. From Ebony to Oprah, what other source do I need for advice? And what couldn't I possibly know about guys?
Ooh, well, excuse me, Miss Ebony to Oprah. Well, I see now my little sister has now become a big girl. Then shall we, let's say, turn to page 2 for a practical experience?
I've had a boyfriend, remember?
Well, in case you've forgotten, I have a memory too, remember?
Max, I don't even know why we're even talking about this. Look, even if BB is a ruffian you claim he is.
He is.
I don't think he has the guts to hassle Mr. Mensah's daughter.
Oh, God. All right. Okay. I see there's no point in trying to put some sense into your 17-year-old head. So fine, I'm not gonna say anything more. That's it. Well, let me tell you something, sweetheart. This BB friend of yours better not have the guts. Because if he does, if he so much as tries, I promise you that I, Maximilian Alexander Xavier Mensah III, I'll shoot him myself. Okay? Boom!
Watch Things We Do For Love carefully and discuss the various issues we will be raising at the end of each episode with your family, teachers, and friends. Today's point of discussion is, how does the information we receive from our friends conflict with that from our parents, as in Pusha BB and Marsha Mother dialogues?
Inside, and no longer could I hide my love.